Any of you who've ever worked on a 99 or a 66 and had a nasty bobbin case like this, you tried to clean it. I mean, there's a lot of rust on this. So, how do you get it apart? More importantly, how do you get it back together again? There is a spring right here that the thread actually goes underneath, and this is the tension adjusting screw for that spring. So it's kind of important how you get these devices apart and back together again. So I'm going to hold in my little machinist vise. I've got the machinist vise on a stand at the moment. It's not really tight on the stand, as you can see. It's kind of flopping. It's just holding it in basic position. So I'm going to take this apart. Start with this little tiny screw up top. And I'm going to grab the screw as it comes out with a pair of tweezers. Set it off to the side. And then I'm going to loosen up the adjusting screw and take the adjusting screw out as well. And yes, this does mean that this is going to have to be adjusted after it's cleaned and reassembled. But I want you to see what you don't see when you just look at these things when it's in place. I got the screw off. Okay, now here's the leaf spring. Let's get the leaf spring out of the way. I'm going to try to do this with tweezers to keep my fat paws out of the way. There's the leaf spring. I'll set that down for the moment. And here's what was underneath that. See all that rust and crud in there? Hold on, let me get a screwdriver. All that rust and crud, that would have been completely missed had I not taken that apart. Let's look on the back of the spring. Back of the spring is just as bad, filled with rust and crud. Now I'm hoping I can clean this well enough so that this spring is going to be reusable. Question of the hour, how to clean this. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put the spring, those two little screws, in a container so that they don't get lost. They're tiny. My weapon of choice is going to be a rotary tool, and we're going to get in there with this style hard felt and get those on Amazon. So I'm going to use yellow compound. We're going to get in here and we're going to polish this. Yellow compound is what I use on the buffing wheels, my bench polishers. I normally, when I'm working with the Dremel, use white. And honestly, this is the first time I've used yellow with the Dremel, and I'm liking what I'm seeing. And I'm using Dremel as a same way one would use Kleenex. It's a rotary tool. I know, this is not a Dremel. This is a Harbor Freight. And if you're wondering why I use the Harbor Freight one, it's because they're essentially disposable. At this price point, I can have a bunch of them. And I do. I've got like three or four of these. And I keep on expecting them to die. This one I was ready to retire. I've been using this one for a couple of years. I was ready to retire it the other day. And it just refuses to give it up. It's a little noisier than I'd like, but it's okay. All right, let's wipe off some of the excess schmoo here. Oh, that's cleaning up nicely. There's still a little bit of crud buried, but we'll take care of that and get the extraneous. See how that's all been polished in there. This is coming up quite nicely. The areas that I had feared weren't going to polish, weren't going to clean up, are cleaning up very, very well. These hard felt polishing wheels that I buy from Amazon really are marvelous for this detail work. And yes, the compound does go black. That's okay. And man, does this get hot. And that's okay too. See how I'm using this hard felt polishing point to get in all the recesses. And honestly, that doesn't really matter. That's just a matter of, these don't really, they're not in the thread path. This is just personal pride in getting stuff clean. Fortunately, there's no rust down in the groove. All right, let's wipe this down a little bit more. I just really, really like to restore parts to get them looking really, really nice. And like I said, this is not a customer machine I'm working on. This is a personal project. I have so many of these 99s that I've bought over the past several years. I know I rail about people hoarding featherweights, and I've got a bunch of those as well. Between my wife and I, we have four or five featherweights in the house. I'd have to go looking. I don't remember exactly, but I have a special place in my heart for the 99. I think, honestly, it's represents the best value in a vintage machine. Price versus performance, that you really can't beat them. Let me get some yellow compound on this. Okay. Let's get in here and clean this up. That is getting warm. Friction is our friend, I guess. Let's get the schmoo out. Get into the crevices. That's why these wooden handled swabs are just wonderful to work with. And you can't overestimate the value of a clean and polished bobbin case. This is the beginning of half of your thread path. Well, unless you got a chain stitch machine where you're not running a bobbin, but for any lock stitch machine, you know, keeping your thread path clean and polished is kind of really important. If you want it to be as smooth as possible, no burrs, no crud. So, yeah, some people think I'm a little crazy going to the extent that I do. But I've never had anybody complain that their thread path was too clean. All right, let me set this aside and pull out this spring. Now, the inside of the spring has a bunch of corrosion here. I'm going to go back to the smaller felt buffer. And I'm going to recharge it with some fresh compound. Next step. How to secure this. Let me find I'll use my small non-marring pliers. I'm going to hold that this way. These pliers have a nylon jaw. They're from Beadsmith. They are nylon jawed and they don't mark up anything. And was I successful? Yes. You can see I got all the crap that was inside in the thread path of this cleared out. And just for grins and giggles, I'm going to do the outside portion of this too. Because why not? Flip it around. There. Now, shall we reassemble it? Let's get our ducks in a row here. I'm going to put the spring in its proper orientation back onto the bobbin case, thusly, and I'm going to secure the bobbin case light but firm, get it secured in my little vise, just as a work holding fixture. Okay, now I need the larger of the two screws. And I'm going to start that screw up just a little bit. Don't breathe. Okay, I got that one started. Now I'm going to take the smaller of the two screws. Actually, I'm going to get that a little bit more upright. And set the screw down. Okay, I got the screw started. That screw is tiny. It's probably like an 080 or something like that. And now we'll get the tensioner in. And we'll mess with the bobbin case tension when the machine is back together again and we're reinstalling it. But there you go. If you remember what this bobbin case looked like when I started, this is a tremendous difference. And I think we have brought this back from death and destruction. So I'm quite pleased. Let me know what you think in the comments. All right. Thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next one.